Questions. How are you? How are you now? How's your Christian life? How are you as a disciple? It's been a year since the pandemic struck in our country. And alam natin, lahat tayo naapektuhan. Our school, online classes, good for us if we have internet, our business, our work. Some of us that don't have work, no? Naapektuhan din yung trabaho, yung career, no? Our finances, lahat naapektuhan. Even our life group, some of us, nag-give up na sa life group. As a disciple, how about our faith? Nandyan pa ba? Our leader, as a leader, nandyan pa rin ba? All of this was tested because of this pandemic. Many of us gave up their life group. Many of us, sabi nagpahinga, magpahinga muna. Many give up their leader. And worst, many give up Jesus. Kasi wala ng pag-asa. What is it that we really need in our life? As individual and as a leader, as a disciple, what really matters most in us? Our message, no? Sige, let's open our Bible in Luke chapter 10, verse 38 to 42. In this passage, it says there, as Jesus visited in the village, no? He visited the place of Martha and Mary. They are the sisters of Lazaro. No? While Jesus was sitting in their home, no, in their place, Martha is very busy in the kitchen doing, preparing food in the kitchen, doing the household. And then she said to Jesus, na pwede ba kunong sabihan si Mary, no, na tulungan siya. But sabi ni Jesus, sinabihan din si Martha ni Jesus, nagayahin, tingnan mo si Mary, alam niya kung ano yung important para sa kanya. So this is the story, no? When Jesus visited the house of Martha and Mary. They were friends, so they are very familiar with each other. When Jesus went in their village, Martha was so busy preparing things, while Mary was just sitting on the floor in Jesus' feet, listening to Jesus. So in this passage, no? In this passage, we can see two pictures. Number one's Martha. Martha knows who Jesus is. Many of us, just like Martha, many of us knows who Jesus is. We even know and very familiar in his story. Every Holy Week, many are commemorating his death. But do we really know the significance of his death? Next week, we will be celebrating, no? We will be celebrating the so-called Holy Week. A lot knows it, but maraming baliwala na lang. Martha knows Jesus, but because of familiarity, there is no excitement of his presence anymore. So busy of the things of the world, so busy of the demands of life, so busy of the wants in life. We were so occupied by worries. No? Just like Martha, she's worrying of everything. Worried if makabalik pa ba sa dati tayo, especially now that we are more than a year in quarantine. Worried if makapag-asawa ka pa ba? If you are single, especially now, virtual na ang fellowship. A lot of worries in life, a lot of distractions, problems, and even offenses from our leaders, from our disciples. No, these are the things that without us knowing can take us away from the presence of God. Even our basic lifestyle, which is the devotional life and prayer, Sunday celebration, life group, and even training, hindi na natin nagawa. Siguro pa minsan-minsan, dahil nga busy sa kung ano-ano. Even in winning people to the Lord, we delayed it or dili na lang muna. I'm not saying that we will not be worried, but the Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 6, verse 34, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. Even in Matthew 11, 28, cast your burden upon me, for my yoke is easy and light. We are always busy. You know what busy means? Be under Satan's yoke. He makes us sure that we are always busy so that we will not be in the presence. We will not have time in the presence of God. Make sure that in our busyness in life, we still make God our priority. We make Him the center of our life, because if we make God our priority, alam ni Satan na wala na, talo na siya. Number two picture here is Mary. She was so attentive in Jesus and listen to him, what he says. She knows that she needs to help Martha in doing the household chores or in preparing the food in the kitchen. But still, she chooses to stay with him, with Jesus. We can understand here that even they are friends with Jesus, but very rare that he will visit in their home. Maybe in their hometown, Jesus will pass by or visit to do the ministry, but staying in their house or visiting in their house, it's a different story. Pag meron kang kakilala or meron kang friends, no family friends, na dumaan lang sa lugar niyo. But ibang usapan pag nagstay, nakitulog, nag-spend time sa'yo, ibang usapan yan. That is why Mary choose to stay and listen to Jesus. In our life also, we have choices to make. Choices to do our devotional life daily, choices to our prayer life, choices to have life group, choices to attend our life group, choices to obey the Lord and His commands, choices to obey our leader or our pastor. We have many choices, but when you obey the Lord, it means you love Him and you are interested in what He will say to you and what He wants you to do. It's like when you are in love with a person. He or she occupied the space in your mind and in your heart. Parati mo na lang siyang iniisip, lahat na lang ng gagawin mo. You keep on thinking on what to give to him or to her, what she wants, what she's interested to. Parang siya na lang, kinukwento mo pa sa iba, no? Ang nangyari, kinukwento mo pa kung anong feelings mo, ganyan. You always want to please him or her. Ganyan ang in love. Pag mga mansary, anniversary, yung mga sari-sari dyan, no, mag-absent or kung kaya mag-leave para sa from work, but just to celebrate with the love of your life. So how about with the Lord? Are we spending time with Him? Are we doing, no, what He wants us to do? Do we have that eagerness and excitement to meet Him today or in our daily life? No, our mentor, Pastor Rafi Lagat, always told us and emphasized in us the importance of prayer and the Word of God. Even if you are busy in life, but yet you have time for the vision in winning souls and making disciples, then you know your priority. Dapat alam natin, kahit may trabaho ka, dun ka, gagawin mo dun sa area mo kung saan ka nilagay ni Lord. When we love the Lord with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our mind, spending time with Him, winning people, discipleship, life group, even attending the trainings, like our life class is School of Leaders training. These are also easy and not a burden in our life. Madali na lang, excite with excitement pa. Because the key is that we love the Lord so deeply. Jesus is interested in us, no? He is also mindful in us. In Psalm chapter 8 verse 4, what is mankind that you are so mindful of them? Human beings that you care for of them, no? Jesus is interested in what we are interested into, like school, gusto mo matapos ang pag-eskwela mo, your work, your business, your marriage, no? Are we interested also in Him and in His ministry? Most of us Christians are defeated in life, maybe because we still don't know what matters most in our life. When we visit Israel, when we went to Israel, there I can see somehow the ministry of Jesus is not that easy. Naglalakad sa init at sa paglalakad nila, yet every day they are doing the ministry. Walang sasakyan nun, paa lang, at nakita ko na puro hill, buntod-buntod, no? Yung area doon. They feel tired but still go on in sharing the gospel. That is why, nung tinanong kami ni Pastor Rafi to share anong experience namin, sabi ko doon, na grabe yung nakita namin, and that is why I declare there sa Israel that no matter what problems pa ang dumating, no pains can hinder us in doing what the Lord wants us to do. Like Mary, Jesus is what matters most in her life. How about us? Before this day end, try to ask these questions and write your answers in your notebook. Mas maganda kasi kung isulat. Kasi pag nabasa mo ulit, mas ma-remind ka. In Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 2, write down the revelation and make it plain on tablets. No, mas maganda pag isulat. What am I doing? So isulat mo tong mga tanong na to. And balik-balikan mo every day. Or maganda kasi kung balik-balikan mo siya. Am I doing what the Lord wants me to do? Am I obeying Him? Even if medyo mahirap gawin. Is Jesus really matters most in our life? Is His ministry really matters to me? Am I interested in what Jesus is interested in? Remember that Jesus' heartbeat is for the people. What really matters to me now? These questions are really worth spending time. And honestly, kailangan natin gawin yun, no? And malaman din natin kung ano na ba talaga. Ano ba talaga yung priority natin? Ano ba talaga yung kailangan natin? Or what really matters sa atin, sa life?